Hello, Flat Earth researchers, debaters, and debunkers. Instead of doing any scientific, tangible measurements of the curvature that is assumed to exist on the surface of a globe Earth to prove a point, your average heliocentrist has only one argument, and that is that there is a dip of the horizon. When we gain height above the surface of the Earth, we apparently see this dip of the horizon that goes below eye level. And this is passed off as evidence or proof that we live on a globe and the mathematics all works out without any need to verify this with any kind of proper measurement. Because of course, we're talking about an observation that has a calculation or a way of being measured in a different way to a physical or tangible measurement using a ruler or some other kind of measuring device that can give you accurate distances, whether those are vertical distances or distances across the Earth. And this really is an irrelevant argument, because what we're really talking about is perspective, and perspective being created in our eyes, an optical phenomenon, because we see everything get smaller in angular size over distance. This is what gives us our depth in our field of view, just as we see depth in a two-dimensional painting that has incorporated perspective, with things appearing to recede in angular size in the distance. So of course there are calculations for angular size, but what you end up with is not a tangible measurement, but something that is just calculated in terms of degrees. So we have this conversion of a physical size into an apparent size, and that's all relative to the field of our vision, which again really isn't tangible. We know that physically distant parallel lines that maintain a physical distance apart will appear to converge in the distance, whether that's train tracks or a corridor or something like that, appearing to converge. And there is a limit to the distance at which we see that convergence. Beyond that, we won't see anything else that's happening beyond it. You can flip that on its side as well, and of course that's what we see when we have a level surface, and that appearing to rise up to our eye level, and the clouds in the sky, or maybe lights in the sky, appearing to descend down towards the horizon in this cone of perspective. If you're looking at it side on, it's going to be a cone of perspective. And that's how angular size is calculated or illustrated, as a cone of perspective, right? Angular size is only to do with our observations. It has nothing to do with the actual tangible physical size of something. And of course, you can create calculations with various assumptions of the initial physical size, and then imagineer a distance that the object is based on its assumed size. Like any mathematical calculation, you can start with a fixed number and then calculate the results you would expect from that. So what we're going to do is just have a look at whether this apparent assumed drop or dip of the horizon from eye level is something that would work on a flat Earth. Of course, we are told that it wouldn't work on a flat Earth, but in reality, the horizon is not something that's fixed. You can make this observation anywhere you like. You will see the horizon is always at your eye level. The horizon tells you where you are in relation to everything else around you. It is your eye level indicator, or it tells you how high you are above the surface or in relation to other objects in the foreground, in front of the horizon. That's what it does. So straight away, just by looking at reality, you can know that the horizon is not a fixed geometric curve. But we have some mathematics for that based on the assumed radius of the Earth. And we can assume, for example, that if you're 2 meters high, your eye level is about 2 meters high above the surface of the Earth, regardless of whether you consider it level or curved. The distance that we will see to the horizon on the surface is calculated to be somewhere between 3 and 5 kilometers. And so we can use these calculations to assess this idea that a drop from eye level to the horizon is anything to do with us being on a globe. Let's have a look at the blackboard and this illustration I put here. We've got an aircraft that is flying 5,000 feet, I'm sorry, meters or 5 kilometers above a level surface. All right, so we're going to do two things here. We're going to talk about the distance to the horizon according to the official mathematics of how far we should be able to see to the horizon, given the geometry of a spherical Earth at a height of 5 kilometers. It's well known, of course, and this can be checked out in reality as well, that the higher you go above the surface, the further across that surface you will see until the surface begins to condense. So this kind of fits with reality, but it doesn't mean that we are looking down to a curve, a curved surface. It just means that the higher we go, the further we can see, the wider our cone of perspective gets, as it were. So we got a height of 5 kilometers, and according to websites such as ringbell.com, which gives you this calculation, the distance to the horizon when we are at an eye level or a height of 5 kilometers is 252.6 kilometers to the horizon. So that's why I've got 5 kilometers here as the height. Yes, it's not to scale, in case you didn't notice that. But no, none of these drawings ever are they, really, whether you're talking about any kind of Earth science calculations. And we have a distance between the aircraft and the horizon point, which is here, of 252.6 kilometers. Okay, that's the calculation that we've got for the distance to the horizon. So we are going to assume, based on this official mathematics, that that is as far as this pilot can see to the horizon at a height of 5 kilometers, according to the official maths, all right? And then we're going to look at the angular size, which is often referred to as the angular diameter of the gap, which is 5 kilometers between the surface and the pilot's eye level, at this distance of 252.6 kilometers, and we end up with a very negligible 1.13 degrees. You can talk about angular size in radians or degrees or arc minutes or arc seconds, but all of these are based on this circle, basically, that is the base of our cone of perspective. So here I've illustrated this as a diameter. So let's assume that we have this, if I can just maybe put this, what this is basically this here. All right, okay. So we have this 5 kilometer thing, base of the cone of perspective, and that is tapering off until we get this angular size here of this gap, which translates into 1.13 degrees. All right, again, it's not a tangible or physical measurement, it's just how our eyes would see a gap of 5 kilometers across a distance of 252.6 kilometers. We end up with this angular size of 1.13 degrees. You can't put it into kilometers anymore. So, of course, a parallel line, just as we explained earlier, and we know, is an equal distance between this top one and the bottom one forever, but we know that we don't actually see it that way. We will see this convergence, and so here at this point, 252.6 kilometers here, is where the pilot should be seeing his or her particular subjective horizon. Okay, and well, we, you know, physically we still have this gap, which is as wide as this gap, but we can say then that we would have a horizon that is equivalent to 1.13 degrees. So we've really got this tiny, tiny drop here that might occur. Well, basically this gap turns into something that's only this size. Let me try and find a better pen, okay? You know, we've got a gap here between the horizon or the eye level and the surface, which is only 1.13 degrees in angular size. So of course, in order for that to happen, we have to have this go up here like this. All right, that's going to be like that. Yeah, now really the cone of perspective is more something that is covering with the eye level in the middle. Okay, so actually what we have here is a much larger cone of perspective, which will taper to the horizon point here, the distance that we can see across the surface. But actually we might be able to see a bit further across the sky because it's transparent. Yeah, so we do indeed have this surface here appearing to rise up to this point. And so all we have here on a level Earth is something that works absolutely fine, given the calculations that this gap of 5 kilometers will indeed appear to be a gap that is slightly below our eye level, because the surface is already below our eye level. It's just that this gap has decreased in angular size. That's all it is. So when someone tells you that there is a dip at the horizon, first of all, that's something that you really should go out and try and verify yourself, because of course the other things that affect what you see are things like clouds and haze and all sorts of stuff between the surface and your eye level. And if the pilot is above the clouds, then the clouds become the pilot's surface. So you'll actually have a surface that is a lot closer to the pilot's eye level than the Earth's actual surface. All of these are the kind of factors that you need to think about, and really just shows that it doesn't matter what kind of calculations you use, you still don't have any physical measurements of this assumed curvature. All you have is an argument that works perfectly with us being on a level Earth and a decrease in the angular size of the gap between you and the surface, because in our eyes, parallel lines always appear to converge. Thank you very much.